Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Cepheus the King is a constellation that is well-placed at this time of year in the evening. It sits above Polaris, sandwiched between Cassiopeia the Queen to the east and Draco Cygnus to the west and south. Find the brightest star, Alderman, by drawing a line 20 degrees from Shadir and Kaf on the northwestern edge of the W in the Queen. At magnitude 2.4, it is visible from most any location in the northern hemisphere. Alderman is in our stellar neighborhood at just 49 light-years away. Considered a dwarf star, like our Sun, though containing 1.9 solar masses and a radius 2.5 times that of our host star, a fascinating feature of Alderman is its rotational period. It spins 125 times faster than the Sun, which takes nearly a month to revolve, just once. Nearby in the sky is an altogether different star, Mu Cephei, also known as the Garnet Star, due to its deep, intense hue. Unlike Alderman, which is very white, Mu Cephei gets its color from its red giant status, and is quite different from Alderman, despite appearing slightly dimmer. Mu is one of the largest stars visible to the naked eye, though you may need binoculars to see it from more light-polluted locations. But check this out. Mu is around 100 to 120 times farther away than Alderman is. So given that it is only 5 times dimmer on average, that means it is intrinsically far brighter. Alderman is 17 times as bright as the Sun, while Mu Cephei is, are you ready for this? 350,000 times as bright as the Sun. It's also huge. If it replaced the Sun, its radius would extend to halfway between Jupiter and Saturn. And like many red giants, it varies in brightness. For Mu, that goes from magnitude 5 up to 3.6 over an irregular period. But despite its brightness fluctuations, it has been used since 1943 as a stable spectrum anchor point. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. Turn off those electronic devices an hour before sleep. Artificial light exposure between dusk and the time we go to bed at night suppresses release of the sleep-promoting hormone melatonin, enhances alertness, and shifts circadian rhythms to a later hour, making it more difficult to fall asleep, says Dr. Charles Seisler of Harvard Medical School. Other interesting objects await nearby. On the way from Alderman to the Garnet Star, check out this little diminishing triplet of stars with binoculars. An important star on the other side of the King constellation is Delta Cephei at the apex of this small triangle of stars. The work of Henrietta Leavitt, who discovered the logarithmic relationship of Cepheid variable stars in the Magellanic Clouds, is what set the foundation for Edwin Hubble's work of proving that there were galaxies beyond our own. And last but not least, a double, and for large amateur scopes, triple star. A line from Alderman towards Iota Cephei, but stopping at just 5 degrees distance in the middle of the constellation, is Xi Cephei, a lovely telescopic double separated by 7.6 arc seconds. The A 4.5 magnitude star and B 6.5 components make a nice, slightly unequal pairing. A third, very dim, and possibly not even gravitationally bound, 13th magnitude companion is 13 arc seconds away. But dark skies and a scope of 6 or 8 inches or larger are likely required to spot that. Venus is slightly closer to the south than west now as it skims into Sagittarius this week. Jupiter sits nearly still in Gemini as it shows off the last 5 double moon shadow transits in early November. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.